Hi and welcome to this video. My name is Carl and today we're going to talk about process mining and also NPM, which is the process mining tool that I use to follow up processes. Let's just start with explaining what process mining really is. So process mining is shortly an analysis of business processes that can be retrieved from digital footprints. In process mining, we use data-driven techniques to retrieve, analyze, and improve processes. Maybe you're just wondering, what is a process? And take an example to clear things out. Imagine being the retail corporation who sells clothes. This company wants to know how the full process of selling one pair of pants looks like. So the full process for selling one pair of pants is from start to end. And in between, there is a lot of events, which is the thing we want to mine. Okay, but what is an event? Just keep watching. Right, so the first event will be when a consumer decides to order a pair of pants. In this case, some nice looking silver pants. After the order is received at the company, these pants need to be picked from the warehouse, which is our second event. After the picking of the pants, it needs to be transported to the packaging area and a packaging event occurs, which is our third. Now, after the picking, this item needs to be delivered to the customer. This is often something that consists of multiple events, but in order to simplify things, we will only count this as one event. After the package is received at the customer, the process is complete, and the company can monitor this and keep track of the processes of selling one pair of pants. And that's not too much to keep track on. But what if the pants don't fit? Then a new event occurs, return. And when the returned item reaches the warehouse, it needs to be repackaged and also warehoused again. And worst of all, a refund. Obviously, this is a very simplified version of how it looks like when buying one pair of pants. But the lesson is, something as simple as just selling one pair of pants can include a lot of events. This following picture is the real example of the 10 top process variants that occurs in a similar process. What we can see is that it's quite a lot more actual events in NPM in contrast to my example. And what we also can see is that the top 10 processes variants stands for more than 75% of the total number of cases. So a small amount of process variants stands for the majority of the events. Huh?
Jeez, so many events, Carl. Why do we even care?
Okay, so first of all, by using a process mining tool such as NPM, you can provide a clear and comprehensive view of a business processes, making it easier to identify bottleneck, inefficiencies. What?
Let me rephrase myself. I don't care why it's good. How does it save us money?
As I was saying, by using a process mining tool, we can identify bottlenecks, inefficiencies, and deviation from the process flow. And by doing so, we can also optimize, We can reduce cost, and we can improve the quality of our services. Okay?
I'll take one.
One what?
One process mining tool, one NPM, one of those.
Okay, this is not working. I hope you guys understood a little bit more about process mining. And if you have any questions, please reach out. And if you liked the video, hope you had a great time. Thanks for watching. I'm Carl, and you'll do great.